All right, hello again, fellow coder, to this next video where we are going to dive into further into our series on how to create a Java web app from scratch, leveraging Spring Boot and other technologies. In the last episode, we were talking about Spring Security and using the login page. And as you can see, there is no login page, so we probably have to create our own custom login page. And that is, I did a bit of research before I jumped into this video, and it looks like that is indeed the case. We need to create our own custom login page. So let's go ahead and do that in today's video. But before we get started, let's go ahead and check in our changes from our previous video. I had forgotten to do that, and I always like to just quickly show pretty much all the steps that I go through. So I'm going to go ahead and... Well, actually, I'm going to show you a trick. This is a cool little trick for those of you who might have messed up and you had started coding with some changes in a branch that you didn't mean to do those coding changes in. So let's say you were on one branch, and you started doing a bunch of changes, and then you meant to do it on another branch, and you're like, oh no, and you can't switch branches because it says there'd be a problem to do that. Sometimes you can't switch branches when you do have some changes that you haven't yet checked in. So what are you gonna do? Well, this is where you make use of something called stashing. So you can stash your changes, which means that anything that's unstaged, or even maybe something that is staged, you can stash away and then bring them back into a branch later. So let me show you. Usually the complications around switching branches or what have you is because you have unstaged changes. So you need to get rid of these unstaged changes without checking them in somewhere. So you can stash them. And what you can do is you can type in whatever you like. So I usually just call it like temp or something, because I usually, once you have, you stash your changes, and then once you bring them in, usually you throw them out again, typically. So you can call it whatever you like, but I usually just call it temp. And don't forget to keep staged changes if you do have staged files that you, for some reason, need them to be staged, but whatever. I don't have any staged files, so I will uncheck that and say okay. And what you'll notice is it gets rid of the unstaged files in your branch. At least it should. Oh, it doesn't do this one, though, for some reason. Why wouldn't it do that one? Because that's a brand new file. That's interesting. I would assume that it would be on the... no, it's not. Interesting. So that, I apparently, when you have new files, apparently it doesn't bring them in, or doesn't add them to the stash. So yeah, that's an interesting issue. So if I were to switch branches, would it keep that in? Okay, cool. So it still keeps the file, so that's cool. You'll be able to do whatever it is that you need to do. Fair enough. So if you create a new branch... Or if you're, as you can see, I could switch the branch, no problem, right? I could switch back to the first branch, and there's no issues with doing that. And then if I want to, I could reapply the stash onto this branch if I really wanted to, but I don't. What I want to do is I want to create a new branch, and I want to create it based on the master branch. So I will go ahead and do that. So FreshVotes 005, and this was getting started with Spring Security is the branch I want to create. And then the files that I have stashed are what I want to put onto this branch. So right now in my working copy, I only have that one file, but I want to bring in more files. So what I can do is I can right click and say apply stash, whatever the stash is called. So I can apply that stash and say, are you sure you want to apply the stash to your working copy, which is the current branch that I'm working on? So yes. And then I also usually delete the stash after I apply, just so I don't have a whole bunch of stashes sticking around cluttering things up. So you can apply those changes, and now in your working copy, you will see all of the files that you had previously stashed, okay? So you can stage them, and then you can say, creating or getting started with Spring Security is the name of this, and I can commit and push that branch into GitHub, and then I can do my standard stuff where I need to then get master back up to, right now master is one check-in behind, so I can right-click on the 005 and say merge 005 into master, and then push that to the interwebs, and now my master is up and running. So there you go. That's just a quick little introduction or overview of stashing files. Very useful in certain cases. So let's get into the meat and potatoes of this episode, which is essentially getting our custom form, custom login page built out. So here's my little trick. I'm going to uncomment this code. If you hover over the login page, I think it's a login page, they have a sample login page right here. So again, you hover over not form login, because I don't think this one has this doesn't have an example of a login page, but this one does when you hover over login page. So I usually just cheat and copy this one. I just copy the form part and I bring it into my own new file called login.html, and I create the HTML tags. Should also specify doc type of HTML, and head title is FreshVotes login. The body will be a form, which I'll paste in, right? That's the form that I'd copied from that example. So there it is. And I'm gonna format the code by using Control Shift F to format it the way I like it to be formatted. But then what we need to do is, since we're leveraging TimeLeaf, I'm gonna bring in XML namespace of TimeLeaf and point it to timeleaf.org. What I'm going to do is I'm going to modify this code, because right now this is code meant for a JSP page. So there is unfortunately some massaging that we need to do. So I'm going to take away the action, just because we're posting right to, at least I think we're posting to itself. That should work. If it doesn't, we can always modify it later. And I'm going to modify the CIF tags to be to work for TimeLeaf. So essentially, an if statement with TimeLeaf is essentially, you could just change this into a div. So I could say div thif equals, and then whatever the Spring Expression Language was, and then I change the closing CIF to be a div, right? That's how you convert a CIF to a thif, if you will. But then I have a div inside of a div, but this div essentially becomes redundant, so I'm just going to delete this inner div, because it is, like I said, redundant. And then in here, we have another CIF, and this kind of looks like, we can make this into a div again, so same thing, div, thif, blah, and then change the closing CIF to a closing div. And then cout, we have just a cout inline like this, that's kind of like a span is kind of what it's doing. You could put another div, but then if you put another div, it's not going to work well, because then it's going to be on another line. So if you want to keep it on the same line, you make it a span. And instead of cout, this is essentially th text, right? Or I can do th value equals, right? And then should make a closing span tag separately. I don't know if value is right. I feel like it should be text, because I feel like that's what you usually do for TimeLeaf, is you do th text. Okay, another chif here, change it to a div, thif. You get the idea, right? This is pretty straightforward for converting. And then you can get rid of the inner div because it's kind of redundant. And then we have, okay, label, password, and then remember me configurer stuff. I don't care about the remember me option. That's typically nowadays, you don't have a remember me checkbox because everyone has a built-in solution for password management and stuff. So I don't typically enable that stuff. So there we go. We've created an HTML page pretty simply, right? And it's there. The login page is there. And I believe we're pointing to it with our login page is /login. Now what we might need to do is create a controller to point to it. We'll find out. Let's reboot our code or server and see if this works, but we might need to map it somewhere. We'll see. So if we go to, localhost 8080, the homepage works. If we go to /dashboard, it tries to redirect us to /login. It says it can't find it, and that's probably because there is no mapping. So we need to have a listener for that. Essentially, I say listener, what it is a controller. And I'm noticing that our previous controller that we had made called dashboard controller is actually in the FreshVotes root package, which is actually not good. Usually you want to put all your controllers in some sort of separate package. My bad. I forgot to create a package. Usually I create the .web package, okay? And that's usually where I put my controllers. So I'm going to stop my server and I'm going to drag my dashboard controller into the web folder. And then there it is. And I'm going to create a new controller called login controller. And remember to annotate it with controller annotation. And then we can do the request mapping, right? So I'm going to type this in, and then I'm going to show you another way to do this. Value equals login, method equals request method.get. And then this returns a string, call this, you know, login method or whatever. And it should return the login page, right? Now, there's a quicker way to do this right here, the request mapping. There's a quicker way to create this request mapping that does a get. There's a shortcut. It's called get mapping. Okay, and then you can just say value equals slash login. All right, instead of doing request mapping and typing in request method.get with method equals, the shortcut is just to say get mapping. These two are equivalent to each other. Okay, and also by default, since there's only one parameter, you don't have to specify value either. You can just say slash login and it still works. So it's just a matter of, you know, shrinking the amount of code that you need to type to get the same thing done, really. We're lazy coders. So there you go. That's a little tip for how to do that. So now if I reboot my server, let's have a look and see if this actually works. Login page now redirects to our login page that we had specified previously. Cool, right? So there you go. That's how you create your own custom login page. Although right now, if we try to log in, it won't work. We've got, so let's see what the exception is. There's no password encoder. So there's more work that needs to be done here before this login page will actually function. But there you go. This is sort of the quick and dirty way to get a custom login page up and running. And then we can focus, in a later video, we can focus on giving this a makeover to make it look nicer than it does, because right now this is kind of ugly. But I like to focus on functionality first and then making it pretty after, just because that's how I roll. So there you go. That's how you create the custom login page, how you properly point your code to it. And we could even go back and refactor some previous code inside of the dashboard controller where we had the request mapping get. We can just change this to a get mapping slash, right? So again, these two lines of code are equivalent to each other. Okay, so I can just delete the request mapping and then do Control Shift O to import the get mapping annotation. And there you have it. Okay, the only caveat that I would say is the get mapping annotation was only introduced in a certain version of Spring Boot. So not all versions of Spring Boot actually have this. So if for some reason you can't import it and it's not working, perhaps you need to update yourself to a more recent version of Spring Boot via your pom.xml file. Your pom.xml, you specify the version of Spring Boot inside of the parent tag of your pom file. Okay, so again, if you have an older version, you might not have access to the get mapping annotation. And that's the fix. You update your Spring Boot version. Cool. So there you have it. Now, if you're done, if you don't need to, you know, worry about GitHub stuff, you can stop watching this video and go to the next one. If you, again, would like to see what I do with respect to GitHub and checking in the changes and everything, maybe I'll do this one more time in this video. I probably should do it in every video, but yeah, if you don't care about checking in and all that stuff with respect to GitHub, bye, you're good. Thank you for watching. If you want to see what I do with respect to checking in code, then stick around. So currently I'm on the master branch. I guess I can, the quicker way to do this is to check everything into master, because I want master to be the most up-to-date version. So I will stage all of my changes here. And I will say, what is this going to be called? This is going to be called creating custom login page will essentially be the message that we're going with. So I'm going to commit right to master. And then, like I said, this is a quicker way to do it than creating a new branch first and then merging changes and everything. I check them all into master. So now master is ahead of everything. But now I don't have a branch that represents the stuff that I just did, right? Because I want to have that branch available. Well, now I just create a branch from master after I've already checked stuff into it, right? I can create a new branch, call it FreshVotes 006, creating custom login page, right? Like so, create branch, and there we go. So now 006 is in line with the master branch, and I can switch back to master because that's where I want to put most of my changes. So there we go. That's a bit of an easier way to do the branch creation stuff instead of having to, because normally I'd have to switch back to master, right click and say merge, but now I don't have to because master is in line with the most latest branch, which is where I want it to be. So yeah, that's just a little tip for you guys. And also, I just created this branch, but I haven't pushed it yet into the GitHub repository. So if I go to GitHub, I can confirm that there is no FreshVotes branch 006. See, there is no branch called 006. That's because I haven't pushed it yet. So I should push that branch here. That way it'll create 006 branch inside of my GitHub account repository. So if I refresh now, I should see 006 is there. Cool. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That's how you create a custom login page and check in all your code and a little hack for you. And I'm going to switch back to master. And then in the next video, we can dive deeper into implementing a password encoder and actually getting the login functionality working. And then we'll move on to creating a custom user detail service to be able to read user information from our database. Because right now we have it pointing to an in-memory database, which is not good. We don't want to do that in production. We want to actually have it point to a real database. So we will also tackle that, if not in the next video, then in the one following the next video. So I look forward to seeing you there. Take care of yourself, as always. Happy learning, and bye for now.